Hello guys, welcome back to my channel TechGynaresh. Today we are going to create one Android application using Android Studio. I will leave the link in the description for Android Studio. Please check it out. In this application, we will add two text fields and one button, and on that button click we will try to load second screen. So let's get started. After completing the installation of Android Studio, open it and go to File, New, click on New for Project. One pop-up window will appear, select Basic Activity and click on Next. After that, it will ask to enter the project name, package name and language. Please select Kotlin from the language drop-down and click on Finish. Android Studio will take a while to load the project. After that, it will open the project folder. Project we can see multiple folder like manifest, Java, resources. We will use the Java and resource folder only. In the Java folder, Kotlin file will created for respective screen that we are going to add in our application, and the resources folder is responsible for making UI related changes. Now you can see activity-main.xml and content-main.xml inside resources layout folder. Any screen is divided into two parts. One is an activity, which is like a navigation bar, and the content-main.xml is for actual work in which we will add UI component. First, we will remove the mail button, which is not required in this application. Don't forget to remove its default generated code from respective Kotlin file, which is mainactivity.kt file. After that, we will change the default hello world label to login page, and we will add leading, trailing and top side constraint for that label so that it will appear in the same position for all size mobile screen. Don't forget to give ID for the label. Now we will add plain text field for username and password, and add leading, trailing and button side constraint for username, password and login button. Also, we will add hint for username and password field. It is like a placeholder in HTML. try to run the app. As you can see, our login screen is ready. Now we will create another basic activity. For that, right click on your package name folder and go to new activity, select basic activity. After that, one pop-up screen will appear. Give the activity name and click on finish. Again, we will remove the default email button for activity bar and remove generated code from its respective Kotlin file. On the new screen, we will add one text view for the user welcome message and a button for logout. We will also add constraint for both. All screen are ready now. We will add on click action for respective Kotlin file. So first we will add one action for main activity.kt file for login button. Now we will add code inside on create function. If you start typing the login button ID, Android Studio will automatically suggest to you that. That's why it's important to give ID for every component we add on the screen. To add an action for on clicks, select set on click listener method. Now we will add a simple if statement to check if user and password should not empty. Inside if we will create one constant intent variable for user home activity screen. An intent is a simple message object that is used to communicate between Android components such as activity, content provider, broadcast receiver or services. Now we will add a username in that variable using putExtra method, so we can get it on our second screen. After that, we will pass that variable to start activity. If everything is okay, it will redirect to our second screen. Let's run it. Okay, now give username and password and click on the login button. It will show the second screen. Now we will change the input type of password field to text password so that the enter password should not be visible. For second screen, first we will change the title of that screen to user home, and we will assign username to text view. Username password from login screen, we have to use the intent object getStringExtra method. At the last, we add onClick action for logout button. Now run the app and give username and password. Click on login button. It should redirect to the second screen, and on click of the logout button, it should show login screen. That's it for today, guys. I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Tech Guy Narish.